And we're going to start with verse 12 of Exodus 20, which is the fifth commandment, which is that we're to honor our fathers and mothers. You know, it's interesting. Parents are common to every person under the sun. Everyone has parents. And so this command applies to everyone. And the principle that underlines the fifth commandment, to honor one's parents, is that there are authority structures in the world. So parents lead their children, and husbands lead their wives and families. Elders lead the church. Governments lead the state. And God is king over all. And at the most basic level, the fifth commandment is a commandment for children to obey their parents. And the reason is because we learn how to obey and honor authorities in our lives by watching our parents, by listening to our parents. Our parents and honoring our parents is like the playground for life. Now, whether you have kids or not, I think that most people will recognize that a child who's raised to honor their parents is a joy to be around. But conversely, most of us know that an undisciplined kid is really quite hard work. And more than that, an undisciplined child will likely turn into an undisciplined adult, one who doesn't have respect for authority. And as a result, he or she will be a person who's far less likely to be fruitful in society. And he or she will also be someone who's far less likely to turn to the Lord in obedience. And that's why the fifth commandment says that a child who honors their mom and dad will live long and happy lives. Now, this isn't a direct one-to-one promise that if you're obedient to your parents, you're guaranteed a long or happy life. But rather, it's stating a truth, a generalism, that obedient children become law-abiding adults. And in turn, they generally live better lives than those who are incapable of living under authority. And therefore, the fifth commandment is as much an instruction to parents as it is to children. Parents need to train their children to be obedient, to honor authority, so that as adults, they'll be people who are obedient to authorities and they'll live well in the world. But what about when an authority figure in my life isn't acting in good faith? What about when I have a horrible boss at work? How do I show honor to that individual? How do I honor God and show God's character in a situation like that? I remember a couple years ago, a friend of mine in confidence said that he was struggling with his boss. In confidence, he said to me, "You know, my boss is absolutely horrible. He's rude, he's dishonest, he's demeaning towards others, he's always self-serving, and to be honest, I just don't respect him. And I can't quit my job because I'm kind of locked in with a contract and with responsibilities. So what do I do?" Now, the first thing I encouraged him to do was, well, you know, we actually live in a free society. You can quit your job. So if you can shift over, that'd be good. But if you're stuck in that situation, what do you do? How does the fifth commandment guide us in that type of situation? How do I give honor to a difficult person who's in authority over me? Well, in this situation, rather than being set against our bosses, God calls us to actually pray for our bosses. And part of reverence may mean that I have to bear with their faults, that I cover them in love rather than despise them because of their sinfulness. And we need to be willing to obey our boss's lawful commands. Now, if your boss asks you to do something criminal, just say no, because you've got a higher authority, that's God. But if your boss is asking you to do something that's part of your job, to do it, and to do it with a cheerful spirit. And I think this also gets us to the next thing. Respecting a difficult boss means that we work on our own heart too, making sure that we don't hold our boss in contempt, that we don't foster a heart that grumbles against them. Because to do so would taint our every interaction with them in a dishonorable way. God calls for his people to honor our fathers and mothers, and this sets us up in life, where we're called to honor and submit to authorities in life.